Good afternoon. Good afternoon. It's beautiful today. It's not raining. Tomorrow, it may be raining. Anyway, I am truly honored to be here for this wonderful celebration of our master's students' accomplishments. Today, we recognize 313 graduates from 9 different master's programs here at Harvard Medical School. Let's hear it for our master's graduates in bioethics. Biomedical informatics. They were louder. Clinical investigation. Clinical research. Come on, let's help them out. Clinical service operations. Whoa! All right. Global health delivery. Healthcare quality and safety. They're shouting above their weight. Immunology. And, which should be loudest of all, media, medicine, and health. They are the communicators. And last but not least, given that we are an educational institution for medicine, medical education. All right, all of you have contributed in substantial ways to the Harvard Medical School community. I hope you feel that you've made the best of your time here. Indeed, your achievements are extensive and impressive. You've investigated disease progression in pulmonary fibrosis. You've used machine learning to decode the human gut microbiome. You've investigated how to improve Alzheimer's detection through biomarker testing. And you've researched how neurotechnology may alter perceptions of personhood and identity. Now, one of you, Douglas was named one of Forbes' 30 Under 30 in healthcare for co-founding Cromie Health. Congratulations, Douglas. Cromie Health uses AI to predict patient demand. But I want to congratulate all of you, the master's graduates. Soon you will funnel your newfound expertise into your professional domains. But you'll be doing so amidst treacherous times. Science and academia are being threatened with catastrophic funding cuts. Essential life-saving research is being canceled altogether. And public health has never been more misunderstood. And of course, Harvard, the institution you are graduating from today, has been the most direct target of the current administration's tectonic shift in priorities. Now, some of you might think that your degree won't hold much leverage in this current climate, but you would be mistaken. The specialized knowledge that you've acquired during your master's studies will help you guide transformative change in your chosen professions. Indeed, you will be the ones in a strategic position to stand up for scientists, to stand up for high-quality, equitable healthcare. That's because you not only understand biomedicine, but you know how to apply the teachings of rigorous scholarship to unrelated and various spheres of influence, public policy, industry, education, communications, and so many more. Graduates, you wield influence. You wield power, the power that comes with knowledge, preparation, and training. All of you have studied and trained in this special place, Harvard Medical School. which has equipped you to go back into the world and combat pernicious pathogens. Pathogens like misinformation, skepticism of science, distrust of academics and healthcare providers. Pathogens. Here at Harvard Medical School, you've incubated highly effective tools for addressing these challenges. Society needs you to deploy these tools to ensure the future of scientific discovery, clinical care, and service for the common good. Now, many HMS Masters alumni before you have wielded that power after receiving their degrees. Take, for example, Comfort Ogar, a 2022 alum of the Master of Medical Sciences in Global Health Delivery. Her master's thesis explored adverse events to COVID-19 vaccines, as well as the policy considerations that go into funding safety surveillance in low and middle income countries. Now, Comfort's training at HMS helped her develop specialized expertise to make her a force for public health. Now, last year, Comfort was elected president of the African chapter of the International Society of Pharmacovigilance, which develops and strengthens drug safety systems in Africa. Not only is her work extremely important from a healthcare perspective, but the in-depth knowledge she carries from her time at Harvard Medical School is helping to unpack and falsify destructive narratives around COVID-19 vaccines, infectious diseases, and more, which have unfortunately seeped into the public discourse in the United States and beyond. Because, yes, it is true that drugs, vaccines, other medical interventions do come with adverse side effects. But only through studying those effects and understanding complex policy factors around drug surveillance can we effectively guard against those side effects. Well, thanks to Comfort, Africa is in good hands. Indeed, Comfort is wielding her power to guard against misinformation and to protect public health. You all, yes, please. You, all our new graduates, have been trained to recognize and address challenges in real time. And you are well prepared to respond. In doing so, you will wield tremendous power. You may have to yield it too at times, but let's hope not often. You will wield your power. And that power will shift tides and it will bridge divides. Now, in uncertain times, we need you all, and we look forward to witnessing all that you will accomplish. We are enormously proud of you.